Good evening, Toastmasters. Toastmaster Dave, fellow Toastmaster and my dear guest. Welcome to a seasoned, rainy, and a congregation where we all gather together year after month, week after week, month after month, and year after week, and it will continue forever. So let me just tell about my topic. My topic is related to the brothers who are held responsible or identified as the reasons for the global financial crisis in 2008. So how many of you are aware of the 2008 financial crisis? Great. So how many of you are aware of the brothers who are associated with it?
Lehman Brothers.
Great. Fine. So before telling me going to the topic about Lehman Brothers, let me just tell ask you something. How do you recognize recession? Means how do you identify? For a disease you have symptoms. For a disease you have symptoms, how do you identify recession for that matter? Can anyone tell me?
Yeah. Unemployment.
Slackness in market.
Okay.
Neighbor losing his job. Neighbor losing his job.
Three continuous quarters of GDP.
Great. All of them are right. So let me just classify the three things which I have come across and can be identified associated with the recession. So there are three things. First is the credit crunch. Lack of funds in the market. The second is the growth rate, which you were saying, GDP growth, degrowth rate. The third and the final thing, I would say unemployment, which one of our man has identified. So let me just get back to the first thing, credit crunch. So when we are talking about recession, there is lack of money in the economy, which leads to lack of opportunity for the new businessmen to come across and gives a stagnant growth in the economy. So let me move to the GDP. Here, my GDP, which is the production of goods and services in any economy, gets shattered because of this. Because I don't have money, so I can't invest in anything. And here, my probability of growing decreases. So let me move to the third and final thing. If I don't have money, I'm not able to invest somewhere. How do I grow? Every one of us knows the outsourcing which we are right now have, India, and followed by many other countries. So when it happens, we don't have money, the GDP is staggered, so the outsourcing goes down, which affects each and every one. So right from the US, the developed economy, to the undeveloped or developing economies like India or China, all get affected. So to highlight these all things of 2008 and 2009 financial crisis, let me just highlight you with a bit of statistics about that particular year. In the year 2008, I'm talking about the 2008 when Lehman Brothers collapsed in 2008, September 15th. So that year, according to the US Department Department of Labor, gives the statistics like 6.1% of unemployment rate in the month of August, and which rose to 10 points, staggering 10 point high in the month of September 2009. And moreover, there are 84,000 net job loss in the month of August itself in US and worldwide 4 lakh and more. So this is how the vicious circle moves around. So I think I've started with the pace where we can understand what recession we are talking about and how this Lehman Brothers played a role in that vicious circle to move around. So talking about Lehman Brothers. Lehman Brothers was founded by Henry Lehman with his brother Meyer and Lear in the year 1850, and though it was continuous growth, it survived the two world wars and the Great Depression of 1930. It was not able to stand the subprime mortgage in US in the year 2000 and more. So they, even beside the fact they were able to come across these all depressions and all, how come it went to a halt because of just a small thing called housing bubble? It happens now and then, right? Software bubble, housing bubble, what the matter? No. So let me just make clear, it was the subprime mortgage which was the main reason for this particular recession. On September 15th, 2007, Lehman Brothers filed their bankruptcy and became the largest victim of the subprime mortgage which US was facing already. Because of this what subprime mortgage crisis which is happening, which is housing bubble, the soaring prices, and from 2000 to 2006 in US, this bankruptcy made this whole issue to a lot more level, and it resulted in $10 trillion of money evaporating from the market, which held all the economies in jeopardy, strangled, and we were out of jobs, out of businesses, and unemployment. Even Lehman Brothers itself was having 25,000 number of employees worldwide, which ended up in one shot. And to extend it further, so this was what Lehman Brothers did, that made what was the mistake of Lehman Brothers. When I came across a lot of research about case studies which was being conducted by Yale University, New York Stern, and even the Harvard Business Review, if I came across, I was able to identify only one or two mistakes which led to the collapse of Lehman Brothers. So let me just move to that. Lehman Brothers, in 2000 to 2006, there was a huge surge in the US property market, housing property market, and because of mortgage properties, people were getting high returns of that. And the main reason for that, the main reason of getting that returns, Lehman Brothers invested in that mortgage lenders, buying the mortgage property to earn more interest and increasing its revenue. So in the year 2003 and 2004, it acquired 5 mortgage firms, mortgage lending firms, which included BNC Mortgage and Aurora Loan Company. These two companies were involved in they call this the Alt-AA funding, which is the subprime mortgage lending. That is, without proper documentation, you lend someone money and in just lieu of getting high returns. This was the one thing which incepted a huge circle where people were stuck inside and were not able to move out. Lehman Brothers made in September 2000 with the fall of this hedge funds which were related to this mortgage lending, people started doubting Lehman Brothers stocks also, which was having a soaring of $86.10 share in the month of September 2008. So if I just want to conclude, there is a borrower who is having his loan against a property, mortgage, with proper documentation. And there is a borrower who is having a subprime mortgage loan. And both are coming to an investing bank to just get a loan. And they get loan. But because of high number of borrowers in the market and a crack in the US housing boom, the properties get filled. What will you do? Will you continue with your loan or you will start to shell it out? And the rational investor will say no. $3 lakh worth of property which he has mortgaged now has fallen down to 90,000. How would he survive? Everyone started to put it down and the total economy went into jeopardy. This was the collapse of Lehman Brothers. So the only message which I wanted to give to every one of you is that in India that time with 8.5% GDP growth rate, we survived. Maybe the philanthropist and the seasoned economist say that because we were having investments gold, which made us endure that situation. But that might not be sure every time. Right now, we are having a housing property boom in India also. And still, people are losing gold now because it is continuous fall and US dollar is continuously rising. I would say, be informed about what you invest. Be informed about what you care. So be smart, be realistic, and live life. Go to Rasmussen.
Thank you. Thank you, Sahil.